but she overcame mental illness and physical disability to become an unlikely hero of World War II. This is the strange and remarkable story of Prince Philip's mother, Princess Alice, one of the royal family's best-kept secrets. Princess Alice Battenberg's start in life couldn't have been more royal. Born at Windsor Castle in 1885, she was a great-granddaughter of Queen Victoria. Although her parents were more German than British, Alice was raised as an English princess. But from childhood, she was set apart from the rest of her family by a profound disability.
She was stone deaf. And my grandmother realized that she had to just get used to coping with her disability herself. She said to the family, look, if Anne doesn't hear and doesn't understand what you said, it's quite important not to repeat it so that she learns to stand on her own feet.
Her mother's tough love worked. By the age of 18, Alice could not only speak clearly, but also lip-read in three languages. And in 1902, at the coronation celebrations of King Edward VII, she met and fell in love with the glamorous Prince Andrew, youngest son of King George I of Greece.
She was dotty about him, absolutely mad for him. Really, really deeply in love. He was very entertaining. And very charming. And she fell hook, line, and sinker.
After their wedding in 1903, Alice set up home with her husband in her newly adopted country. At the royal family's palace in Athens, Alice settled into her allotted role as a princess and mother. In 10 years, she produced 4 daughters and even managed to win over an increasingly anti-monarchist Greek public. This was just the start of 10 traumatic years for Alice and her family. The First World War triggered a decade of conflict in Greece between pro- and anti-royalist forces. In 1922, Republican troops entered Athens. Alice's brother-in-law, the king, fled the country. But her husband, Prince Andrew, was arrested and put on trial by a revolutionary court.
It was also awful. My aunt did have a very difficult time because, of course, there was a definite threat that my uncle Andrea might have ended up being executed for not being on the right side. They must have come under a great deal of pressure.
To add to her worry, and his mother put on a brave face. But beneath the surface, the pressures of exile were beginning to tell.
Ξαφνικά υπάρχει ένα τεράστιο πρόβλημα χρημάτων και ζουν ουσιαστικά με την βοήθεια πλούσιων συγγενών. Για έναν άνθρωπο υπερήφανο, όπως ήταν ο Ανδρέας, αλλά από εκεί και πέρα έχει την αίσθηση ότι ένα κομμάτι του εαυτού του έχει μείνει πίσω στην Ελλάδα και έχει πεθάνει.
While Prince Andrew brooded on his fate, Philip's mother was left isolated and emotionally vulnerable.
For her, it was very, very frustrating when big family groups, which often happened, we would be 20 around the table. And then, of course, she was lost, you know, she couldn't see people's lips. And suddenly, somebody would start roaring with laughter at the end of the table. And she'd think it was a joke about her, which, of course, it never was.
Trapped in her silent world, dark thoughts began to prey on Alice's mind.